Let us understand what is stock ledger account and how it works. This stock ledger account can be prepared in various methods like FIFO, LIFO, simple average method, weighted average method, and so on. Very commonly used are only three: FIFO method, LIFO method, and weighted average method. So let us first understand stock ledger account in the FIFO method. How does this work? Let us understand this stock ledger account using FIFO and by taking an example. On April 1st, in my godown, I had 100 units of rupees 10. I had 100 units of some stock at rupees 10. And the total value will be 1000. This is my opening stock as on April 1. I did not purchase any units as on that date, so I will close my account. I will wait until something happens to this stock ledger account, some transaction occurs. If you have any receipts or if you have any issues, only then stock ledger account will get affected. Let us, for example, let us take on April 5th, I have purchased some more units. I have purchased 2200 units at rupees 11. This can be some other stock than this, or it can be the same stock of this, of different amount. We are not going to mix it. We are going to keep it separately. And that is how, that is what is the beauty of this stock ledger account. So 2000 units I have purchased at rupees 11, total amount will be 2200 units. And I did not issue any of those stock to the production house, and therefore my balance as on that date is this 100 previously which I had, and this is the new stock. So my balance as on that date will be 300 units, 100 and this 200 new stock. This 100 is of 10 rupee and this new stock is of 11 rupee. And therefore, this will be 1000 rupees and this will be 2200 units. My account closes as on that date. Further, on April 9th, I have received 100 units more at rupees 10. This is new stock, this is different stock. And because it is different stock, I am not going to add in this stock. Please remember. This is, the amount is 1000 and I am going to write the same units again here. The new stock, I will write just below that. My account closes as on that date. Now the production house requires some amount, and that amount I will write it now here. As on, let us say, April 15th, I have received a requisition saying that you have to send us 250 units. So I have not issued anything. I have not received anything. Now I have to issue 250 units. Now here comes your FIFO method or LIFO method. This is the first stock, this is second stock, this is third stock. If first stock you are issuing first, then it is called as FIFO method. First in, first out. First in, first out. This is LIFO method. If you are issuing first from this stock, because this is received at last. And therefore, in issues column, I will write not 250 units. I will write 100 units of this and 150 units from the second lot. 100 units of rupees 10 150 from the second lot, that is 11. Hope this is understood. As on April 20, production house requires 100 more units. So April 20, production house requires 100 more units. So how are we sending? First 50 from this stock and then 50 from the next stock. So nothing in the receipts column. Now we are going to write in from the balances 50 here. That is 50 we are issuing to the production house and 50 from the next stock. So how many we have issued? We have issued 100. Here how many we have issued? 250. So we can have every such balances in this stock ledger account. Let us fill it. This 50 is from 11 rupees stock. This 50 is from 10 rupees stock. 50 into 11, that is 550. 550. And then we have 50 of rupees 10, that is 500. How many are remaining? From this stock, only 50 are remaining. So this 50 I will write of rupees 10, 500. This is the stock that we have. Now, do you think if the requirement is more, see, 250 units are required, 100 units are required, and we have only 50 units, so we want to bring some more units. We will purchase on April 25, we will purchase 500 units. And let us say the price was rupees 12 at that point of time. So the amount will be rupees 6000, nothing in issues column. 50, this stock is still there with us. And 500, the new stock that we have purchased will be written just below that. Now every storekeeper verifies whether this balance is exactly available in the storehouse. Your storehouse must have this 550 units. If your units are not available over there, then it is the job of the storekeeper to answer the questions from the higher-ups. And therefore, he has to physically verify whether these 550 units are actually available there. Now, what happens is, when he actually verifies, then he understands that he has 10 units less in his stock. He might have lost due to abnormal loss like fire, like by theft. He might have lost some units, or he might have made some counting mistakes earlier. And therefore, he finds that when physically verified, he finds that 10 units are less from this stock. So what he has to do, he has to show the shortage. Shortage he has to show from this stock 10 units. So to show that, as on 30th April, to show that he has to issue that 10 units so as to reduce 10 units from this stock. So 10 into 10 is 100. How many are remaining from this? Only 40 are remaining. So 40 he will write and 4000. And this 500 stock which is newly received will be remaining with you, 500. Now every storekeeper has to give the balance as on the last date, and this balance is given in the last column saying that this is the total value that I have. See, this will become 10,000. And this will be 540 units value of inventory.